I knew it. It's unfortunate, but I knew it. Secret family, thank you so much for tuning in for another video. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Maggie and I do all types of self-care, spiritual care, skincare type of videos. So if that's something you may be interested in, I would love for you to stick around by hitting that subscribe button so that you never miss another upload. Now today's video is going to be a little bit different because I am doing something that I never really brought to this channel, maybe once before, but I am going to give a reaction on Miss Jazzy Live and her unfortunate pregnancy. So let's go ahead and jump right in. Now when I say unfortunate, of course I don't mean any ill will to her or the children, especially to the unborn. Of course we want her to have a healthy and safe delivery, but my goodness, did we not see this coming, or did we see it coming? I know a lot of reactors, they get on here and they, you know, throw darts and they, you know, speak bad on these ladies and these women, and even though these women may deserve it, you know what I'm saying, I just don't think tearing down other women or, you know, really degrading them the way some of these reactors do, you know, I mean, let's just be honest. I am simply here to just give some insight to my ladies who think this is okay, you know. I stopped following Jazzy, Chrissy, Blizz, all of them, Liv, a while ago, okay. Once I really start to see that, okay, we are not on the same page, we are not in the same mindset, you know, we live two completely different lives, then I really have to take a step back from their channel. But of course, you know, I still get their, you know, they're still recommended. And guys, I just saw this video today finally announcing this pregnancy, this wedlock pregnancy, this forced pregnancy, this like she really wanted this baby, y'all, and now she got it. I really don't understand why she would want to have a family or to have a child with someone like Chris. You guys probably have watched plenty of reactions. You guys probably already know what's going on. I am simply here to just explain. I just really hope she sees my video, because I just want to offer really just some words of encouragement, because you have to really be in a low space. You have to really have real low self-esteem and have no idea who you really are to lay down, let move in, take care of, and have a baby by a deadbeat. Guys, please excuse my frustration. If you go back just a couple videos ago, I've done a video about us women taking back our crown, about us women really putting our foot down and really having some morals and some standards, right? I know we live in a world where TikTok and Fashion Nova world and you know, having to do showing every inch of our body is normalized, you know, it's accepted and it's almost expect it nowadays. And ladies, I am here to tell you, and if you are new to my channel, I am a spiritual queen, okay? You are a spiritual queen, and I invite you to come into the sisterhood. We don't do the drama, we don't do the pregnancies, we don't do the, you know, the cheating and the adultery over here. We are simply women trying to get back into our substance, and we cannot do that when women are supporting these types of behavior, okay? And guys, I am simply just trying to let you know that that is not how God intended us women to live and to be and to accept, okay? Let's get into this, Chris. Lord Jesus. I really feel like Jazzy knows what she's doing. She knows what she's getting herself into. I don't know why she's thinking that a baby is going to keep this man around. Excuse me, he's not even a man. I don't know why she thinks this baby is going to keep a man around. She can't even take care of the four that she have. And it's really unfortunate how these children are, you know, essentially gonna suffer from their mom. You know, their mom's depression, their mom's laziness, their mom's decisions. You know, the kids are ultimately going to suffer, and little Kaylin, her oldest daughter, is just going to have more responsibility on her, and I really wish she would see that, you know? Once I hit number four, y'all, I was done, you hear me? I knew how much pressure and overwhelming and how much work, you know what I mean, it goes into being a mother of four. You know, I have four, and after that fourth one, I went right to the hospital and got some things, you know, burnt, snipped, clipped. You know, because I was there, and that's with the husband, that's with the household, that's with a spiritual foundation, you know. And I think that's what I'm trying to get at. Of course, I don't wish any ill will on this young lady, but I really wish she would start to dig her nose and start to really get a spiritual foundation, okay? And for any of you ladies who think that this behavior is okay, if any of you ladies and my sisters out there who are in the same boat as her, okay, I know these babies aren't getting, you know, being born by themselves, they're not being created by themselves. So I know my sisters are out here seeking and looking for men for all the wrong reasons, and I'm here to tell you that God has a plan for you. God has a plan for your children, and we keep blocking our blessings, we keep interrupting God's plan when we go off and try to make our own decisions. When we make our own decisions, go off on a deep end, you know, and then just hope and expect that everything is going to turn out right and okay. And then you bring a child, you bring another child. Guys, I've seen all the reactions. We know he have other kids out here. He don't even take care of the ones that he have now, sis. So what makes you exempt? What makes you exempt, Jazz? And then you put the due date at the end, December. Okay, so that means you're what, 3-4 months already? So I knew it was something going on. You know, again, I don't watch and keep up with all of her videos, but I've been seeing the, you know, little here's and there's about her, you know, allegedly being pregnant. And now you just confirmed it, child, and you happy about it. You're, you know, excited, you want to celebrate it. And it's just like, oh my gosh, y'all, like another child, another fatherless child, another single mother. Well, she's pretty much been a single mother, but another statistic, you know, another deadbeat taking advantage of a single mother. Another, I call them spirits. Like, again, if you go back to my videos, I'm very spiritual here, you know. I look everything with a spiritual eye, you know, because we have to really start to discern these spirits, guys, and really start to accept these men for who they are. If they show you who they are, you better believe them. And Chris has showed you exactly who he is. He's been showed you who he was from the first. Then he messed with one of your friends in the beginning or something like that, sis. Like, what in the world are we, what are you giving into? What is so special about Chris that he is taking you from your spiritual foundation? What is so special in having a baby with Chris that all your morals, all your standards, all your common sense just goes right out the window? Like, are we still doing that? And I believe Jassy's older than me, you know. It's the foolishness for me, it's the naiveness for me, it's the pregnancy for me. Like, oh my god, Jazzy, this is what you wanted this is what you wanted all along. But he has proven to you over and over, definitely proven to us, or the audience I should say, there's nothing you can say to convince us or to convince yourself that Chris is a good dad, that he's going to be there, that he's going to lead you. You call it redirecting your kids when he should be redirecting your kids, you know what I'm saying? Or if you call him the man in your life or the man in your home, why isn't he being a man? Why isn't he stepping up and being that spiritual foundation, that natural born leader, you know, that provider? Let's not forget that. So what now? So now your subscribers are going to pay for your baby showers, your arrivals, your move? Like, guys, you don't think this is some type of publicity stunt? Like, just like the Love and Hip Hops and stuff, you know, how they get married or they have babies just for a TV special, you know, or just for everybody to have the oohs and the ahs, you know. But we really looking at you crazy, sis, and it just hurts me because it's hurting the children, okay? Oh lordy, it's hurting the children. You're not setting a foundation. You're showing your daughters that it's okay to lay up with any Tom, Dick, and Harry who calls you beautiful, or who you're showing your kids that it's your daughters, I should say, it's okay to take care of a man and to let him take your car and to spend your money and to eat all your food up from your kids. This is what you're showing. This is the foundation that you are setting for these children, Jasmine. And how don't you see this as a problem? This is the man, the role model that you want for your son. This is the role model you want your girls to look after. I mean, why are we not thinking about this stuff anymore, you know? Because he's cute, because he don't have the money. Let's be honest, he don't have the home, he don't have the income, he don't have the spiritual foundation, he doesn't take care of the kids that he has. The way he treats you on the vlog, Jazz, says it all. So it's like, what else do you need? Because he's there with helping you with your kids sometimes, that he's eligible for your heart, he's eligible for your home, he's eligible to put a baby up in you when he's probably putting 2, 3, 4 more Who knows, Dad? Do you know? Do you know him enough? Have you discerned him? Have you saw how he treats his family? How he treats the, you know, other people? Does he help people? Does he help the homeless? Again, what is this foundation? What foundation has Chris set for you to sit down and have a child with him and bring another child, another fatherless, motherless child into the world? Like, it's ridiculous. It's foolish. It's oh my God, it's hurtful. And I have a scripture that I just wanted to break it down just to see what God has to say about all of this. You know what I'm saying? Because the living in wedlock and just inviting, and guys, this is for all of the ladies, okay? All those mommies out there who are living like this and are creating content like this, and we all, you know what I'm trying to say. Like, all these mommies are guilty, and Miss Chrissy probably over there pregnant too. Like, let's not get it, let's not be naive here. She's probably working on baby number 10 too. Liv is working on baby number 4. You know, with these randoms, right? Shout out to the Lala gang, right? With these random, like literally random, and you're giving your heart and you're giving your lives and you're opening up your home and your freedom and your bank accounts and your food stamps. What have they shown you other than a good drink and a good, what can they provide? Do you honestly and truly and utterly with all 100% of your heart think that Chris is going to be there every step of the way as a father should? Do you honestly, utterly believe that? Or are you just happy just to have a baby by him? I mean, because we all know, I mean, let's face it, we all know what Jazzy really be on, you know? Don't know why. This is the decision you have made, sis, and I really hope you are able to handle what's about to come after this, okay? So again, let's see what God has to say about all of this. He's my dog, y'all. Probably them kids messing with my doggy. About what God says about our bodies and about swapping spirits, about swapping, you know, demons, I like to call them, because that's what they are, that's what they can be, that's where they arrive from, for people to treat somebody or treat their children or treat their family or the one that they, that's not love, you know, that's not unconditional love. Chris might be transactional love, he might have transactional love or circumstantial love, but it's not unconditional love. And so in 1 Corinthians 18 through 20 says, flee from sexual immorality. Every sin a person commits is outside the body, you know, like murder, stealing, you know, that's an outside feeling, right? An outside sin. But the sexually immoral person sins against his own body, right? So think of like porn stars, you know, or think of women give their bodies to these random, disgusting, no good men out here, right? They give their bodies over and over and over, right? Like, to all these ladies, right? That's not, this ain't Liv first dude, this ain't Chrissy first dude, this ain't her first, you know? Again, no foundation, no spiritual nothingness, right? But you're sinning against your own body when you do that, when you continue to give your body up. You continue to have sex and invite all these spirits, no good spirits, I should say, and you wonder why your life is in shambles. You know, you wonder why the same thing, or you keep choosing the same guy over and over and keep, you know, getting the same result. But the sexually immoral person sins against his own body. Or do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you? Do you not know that, sis? Do you not know that we are a precious, tender, you know, valuable, spiritual temple, you know, that cannot be played around with, that cannot just be tossed up and used up like garbage and like trash and then taken out on Tuesday, you know? Because I really feel like Chris is just like, I don't even know if Chris knows yet. I don't even know if he's excited. He sure wasn't in the video. I would think that would be a family thing, you know, or like a family reveal, especially how she tries to convince us so much that he's just this awesome guy. He wasn't even in the video. So like, sis, what is possessing you to be with somebody like that? Something has to be off-centered, something has to be off spiritually, something has to be off physically, you know, for you to accept and to really downgrade your morals, your respect, your common sense for a man like this. All these men, they're not up to par, you know, they're not up to par with what the word has to say, you know, and I don't think any of them are seeking any spiritual foundation. You know why? Because they like what they're doing. They like the drama. They like the controversy. They like the toxicity, and they wonder why they can't get further than where they are now. They wonder why they have to keep reverting back to the same old content, or they're literally stuck in that phase, you know, of toxicity and controversy that they don't honestly know what to do with themselves. They honestly don't know how to be positive. They honestly don't know how to create entertaining content without it being, again, toxic or controversy, you know, and that's a problem, you know? Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you? You are not your own. We are not, this is not just for us to just give away for free. We were bought with a price. We were washed of the blood. We were created anew in His image. But you're continually to let the devil mold your image. You're continually letting the devil choose the man for you. You're continually letting the devil mold your life because you won't choose to do different. All of these ladies, not just Jasmine, she's just the first one, you know? You are not your own, for you were bought with a price. So glorify God in your body, with your body, on your body. Glorify your body, protect it, cover it up, you know? Make them wait, make them work for it, you know? I have 4 children, you know what I'm saying? Well, I'm married, but do you really think, like, if I was a single mother, I'm not letting any Tom, Dick, and Harry come up in my crib that I didn't create, that I didn't mold it, and I really set a solid foundation. I'm not letting no non-God-fearing man up in here. I'm not letting no non-foundational man up in this. Ladies, like, come on now. Like, what are we losing? What are we losing? But gaining our dignity and our respect, right? And our morals. Like, come on now, ladies. Like, we have to do better. We are a temple. We are love. God has a plan for us. And we need to stop letting these dirty, no good ass ninjas stop blocking your blessings, sis. Stop letting these random men be around your kids and your children. You know, you never know with nobody's ill will, because the devil is very real and very evil. And will put some messed up stuff in the wrong person's head who just might be around your kid. Do you understand? I don't think you do, but I really think we need to get that inkling. We need to get that discernment. We need to get that spirit of awareness sharpened. You know what I'm saying? But you want to make gender reveal cupcakes. Oh, Father, 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 just give her the clarity. Give us all the clarity. Give us all the discernment, Lord, that my sacred sisters still need, you know, if they think this is okay and normal in the eyes of you, Lord, and it's not. Jazz, you need to watch some of my videos. I encourage you to watch some of my videos and to really dig deep into your mind and into your spirit, into your heart, and really, really see what's missing, because something has to be off and missing for you to go down the road and the path you're continually going down. There's been no upgrade. There's been no character, There's been no character growth throughout this movie, you know? And it's really, really getting out of hand. And now we have a whole another tiny human life who's about to suffer at the hands of depression, of the hands of laziness, of the hands of singleness, meaning her being by herself, in the hands of overwhelmment, meaning too much going on in the household for the baby to even function and to develop, right, you know? So Lord, I'm just praying for the safety of these kids. I'm praying for the minds of these children, Lord, to be restored and to not be broken as their mother is, because their mother has to be broken somehow, and only you can fix it, God. But give us that choice, Lord. You give us that choice to choose your word or to choose this world. And it looks like she has made her choice, unfortunately, ladies. But we don't have to do that. We don't have to be like Miss Jasmine's. We do not have to be like Miss Chrissy to get a view, to get a like, to get a cash app. We don't have to do that. Our blessings come from the Lord, not from YouTube. And the sooner we realize that, the sooner we can deter from everything else, all right? Oh, sorry, y'all. I didn't really want to make that video too long. But I just had some stuff on my heart. I had to get off. Jazzy, we have to do better. It might be a little too late now, but I just really hope that this molds you. This molds your minds. I really hope you go to the doctor, get those tubes tied until you get yourself together, okay? You need to be done having children. Like yesterday, like 3 months ago. Like, you need to be done having these babies and having nobody to take care of them properly. All right, my sacred friends. sorry for all the rambling. Again, if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I do all types of soul care videos that we so desperately need in this godless, godless world that we're living in. But it is possible we can still be that light that this world needs. And we do that by keeping our head in the world and not making those types of decisions, okay? I love you guys so, so much. Thank you for tuning in, and I will see you in another video.